by Jack Hillcox, news reporter. Dinner for One is a cultural phenomenon. The 18-minute British sketch has dominated German television every New Year's Eve since 1972, has spawned catchphrases and drinking games, and is almost unheard of in the UK. The black and white sketch stars Freddie Frinton as James, an elderly butler serving May Warden's Miss Sophie on her 90th birthday. Miss Sophie has invited her four closest friends for a celebratory dinner, the only problem being that these friends are all long deceased. James is forced to take the place, stumbling around the dinner table, adopting the voices and personas and making toasts on the behalf, knocking back four glasses of sherry, white wine, champagne and port in the process. This is clearly not the first time James has had to endure this alcoholic onslaught. Before each course, James asks same procedure as last year, to which Miss Sophia replies same procedure as every year. This has become a common expression in Germany, and is an accurate summation of the attitude of German audiences to the much-loved film. The sketch ends with a soused and unsteady James escorting Miss Sophie up to her bedroom, with an innuendo-laden, same procedure as last year, well, I'll do my very best. Millions of Germans plan the New Year's Eve celebrations around the sketch and can quote it line by line. Some even attempt to match James' drink for drink, which is no mean feat. According to The Hollywood Reporter, more than 17 million people, around 21% of the German population, tuned in to watch the sketch on the 31st of December 2016. By comparison, the most watched show in the UK was the final of The Great British Bake Off, which was watched by 15.9 million people. The Dinner for One craze has also spread to Scandinavia, South Africa and Australia. Despite this international success, only 13% of Brits have ever heard of the film, and just 8% said they have actually seen it. Dr. Rainer Stallmann, professor of cultural studies at the University of Bremen, says most Germans are unaware of the beloved film's obscurity in the UK. 90% of Germans have not realized this, Professor Stallmann told me. Germans know it as well as they know some of the grim fairy tales. They can quote lines from it. Unsuspecting Brits in Germany might even have the film's catchphrase thrown at them by Germans, assuming the sketch is as well known in the UK as it is Germany. Why did this sketch find a home in Germany and fall into obscurity in the UK? A spokesperson for NDR, a German broadcaster that airs the sketch, said it had a timeless humor, which harks back to a nostalgic memory of a time when the entire family used to come together to watch TV. Professor Stallmann argues Brits are put off by the sketch as it forces them to confront the country's class structure as well as painful moments in its imperial past. The butler repeatedly stumbles over a tiger skin rug laid on the floor, a clear symbol of Britain's occupation of India. The film doesn't have this connection in Germany. Professor Stallmann argues that German audiences merely see the sketch as an illustration of a British flair and, despite appearing quintessentially British, exudes German humor in a British costume. Regardless of the cause of the sketch's popularity, it has been a mainstay of German festive viewing for nearly 50 years. So, German audiences remain captivated by this silly piece of British slapstick from the 60s. It is a comforting routine. The same procedure as every year.